This video is one out of four explaining how to create this wooden toy. This series will illustrate how to potentially create any 3D element, especially with solids. In this drawing, we see the scheme of the wooden toy that we created in 3D. These are simple entities such as rectangles, circles, and ellipses. There are also some more complex figures, which combine lines and arcs to create closed polylines of singular shapes. The goal of each shape is to create a single closed polyline. This is crucial to create a three-dimensional solid, using commands such as Extrude or Revolve. We will further combine the 3D solids using the Boolean operations Union, Intersect or Subtract. By combining basic 2D tools with a few unique 3D tools, we can easily create almost any kind of three-dimensional object to finally achieve this goal. In this video, we're going to focus on the saddle and the structure that supports it. We'll create this piece of solid wood with a hollow interior where screws will join this wooden part with the bicycle frame. We will need two closed polylines. One, defining the outline, is ready, but the interior one is not closed yet. Indeed, it looks like if it was closed, but it is not a single polyline, which is what we need to create the hollow inside the future shape. But we'll take care of this issue. How do we create this closed polyline? We have three possibilities. First option, use the polyline command and redraw each segment on top of the other entities. Second option, use the edit polyline command. On a segment of polyline, it allows us to attach other continuous segments. Third option, use the area boundary command. Click in the drawing. RS Commander will find the closest closed area around the selected point and create a closed polyline around it. We can use any of these three methods as long as we have a closed polyline in the end. In this case, we will choose Edit Polyline. Simply write Pedit and press Enter. Select a segment. If the selected segment is not a polyline, an arc or line, RS Commander warns us and gives us the option to turn it into a polyline. So we specify Yes and press Enter. Now that segment is a polyline. As a result, we can use the Join option to join other parts. Type J and press Enter. Press Enter twice to end the operation and exit the command. If you click again on the entity, you see that we have now a single and closed polyline. Let's review. We have a closed polyline here and a closed polyline here. With these two closed polylines, we will be able to get two 3D solids. We do this with the Extrude command. Let's select the workspace 3D modeling. In the Home tab, we find the Extrude command. Select both polylines and after pressing Enter, define a height of 2 units for the extrusion. Let's move to an isometric view. And change the shading mode. As we can see, there is a solid inside another one. To create the hollow, we must perform Boolean operations, which are union, subtract, and intersect. In this case, we will use subtract. Select the outer solid with a click. Press Enter. Select the interior solid and press Enter again. The result is a 3D shape with a hollow. To create the saddle, we go to the rectangular shape that we see from the front view. By using Extrude, we will get a first shape. This is not the final form, but it allows us to easily determine the correct working layer to eventually get the final form. Let's do it. Extrude 10 units. We go to the isometric view and 2D shading mode. Move the prism so that the midpoint of this piece matches the midpoint of the face of the other element. We draw two reference lines. This process would be correct if the seat had a rectangular shape, but that's not the case. However, we can use this prism to easily locate the working layer we really need. For example, the upper level. Look at the UCS. X indicates this direction and Y this one. Applied to the prism, this would be the X direction and this the Y direction. The Z axis indicates this direction. If we draw a circle, it has only two dimensions, in level X, Y, or a parallel. We need this circle to relate to this surface. For that, we have to relocate the UCS. Here we have a choice of three points. We first indicate the source. Then the directions of X, Y, and Z axes. Now the working layer is on the upper side of the prism. We draw a circle with a radius of 3.7 units. And on the opposite side, another circle with a radius of 2.60. Now move the two circles so that one of its quadrants matches the midpoint of the side of the prism. Next, we combine the two circles with an arc on each side. Draw the first one and then perform a symmetry. This is the shape of the saddle. Now we need a single closed polyline to create a solid. We use the trim command to remove the unwanted part. You can create a polyline using any of the three methods discussed earlier in this video. Like above, we choose Edit Polyline. Select an arc, answer yes to the question asked by RS Commander, and select the Join option to unite it with the neighboring sections. Now we use the Extrude command. Select the polyline and indicate a negative value of minus 1.5 units. Structural element is placed inside the saddle. Go to the isometric view. Turn off the layer of the vertical entities. We see that the seat is solid. For the vertical element to go inside, the saddle should provide a notch to receive the vertical element. To create the notch, we copy the vertical element on itself so two equal elements exist in the same place. Select the solid structure with the copy command and choose a start and end point which should be the same. Now we have two identical overlapping solids. Select one with a click and change the layer. Next, we turn off the layer of the original structure. Then we use the Boolean subtract operation to subtract the solid structure from the saddle. And we achieve the notch we wanted. If we need to go deeper, we just subtract the part that should be stuck in the saddle.